All right, today we're checking out Sarah McLachlan. We're listening to the song Possession. Let's get into it.
Listen as the wind blows from across the great divide. Voices trapped in yearning, memories trapped in time. The night is my companion, and solitude my guide. Would I spend forever here and not be satisfied?
Okay.
What do you think?
I think it's creepy.
Why is that?
I mean, I'll literally like suffocate you with kisses until you close your eyes. That's next level.
Yeah, I wasn't listening to the lyrics as much. I was listening to the vocals.
Yeah. But
there's like an echo on them. Like, you know what I mean? So it's like your first time hearing an artist, we're getting the echo. So it's hard to concentrate on the vocals. Because they have them layered.
Right.
For most of it, not all of it. Like the second verse started, it wasn't so layered, but then they brought the layering back.
Right.
I don't know. I'm trying to get a feel for these vocals.
I want to hear acoustic of this or something.
Yes.
She's got a nice voice.
Yeah, exactly. Acoustic would be amazing.
I'm learning.
Thank you.
Okay.
I see you're talking about the creepy stuff.
Yeah. I see. Pretty creepy.
Well, she's telling us she wants to be dreaming because there's nothing that comes between, you know, her and the dude there. Yeah. And she can't be denied.
Yeah. Like,
ooh. Like, would you really want someone to be this, I don't even want to say in love, but like this attached to
you? I don't know. You tell me.
I don't know. I should tell you. That's just a little extreme. Because, you know, they get suspicious for any reason and they try to kill you or something, right. You know?
She called it possession. I bet it feels like that, though, like to be inside the mind of someone who is like that obsessed with someone.
You're possessed by them.
Well, like you're possessed to like stalk them.
Yeah, like they put like a love spell on you. Then they probably didn't, but it probably feels like that.
Mm-hmm. Like you can't function without being a stalker. Like you can't, like you're obsessed with them to the point that like your existence depends on like stalking them.
I would like to talk to someone who feels like that about somebody. That's,
oh.
That'd be a great conversation to have. I'd love to know what that feels like.
Yeah.
I mean, I'd just be interested to talk to, you know what I mean?
I mean, maybe through like, you know, those like in prison, like the glass, you know, and you'd like pick up the phone and you're both on.
Oh, no, right here on the couch. just dig into their mind.
Oh, man.
You know what I mean? I bet the Sarah McLachlan girl, I bet she's good looking.
Yeah?
The good looking girls are always the craziest. Always. Really? You know what I mean? You like Jodi Arias type.
True. Jodi Arias is especially crazy, though.
Yeah, it's the good looking. They're always crazy.
Okay.
Not not 100%, but like of the girls that are super crazy, a good majority of them are attractive.
Oh, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man.
You don't think so?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, Jodi Arias is a good argument because, I mean, you would never look at their
Casey Anthony.
You'd never understand why.
I'm not saying they got to be models, but you know what I mean? On the scale of attractiveness, they're more attractive.
Okay.
And yeah, not 100%, but I think of the craziest women, the majority are attractive. Maybe 60-40 or something, you know?
This is a study.
70-30.
I've not partaken in.
Yeah, me either. But I know a few crazy people. You know what I'm saying?
I know exactly what you're saying.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know.